If we need to use one sentence to describe the consort Yu, I will say she wasn't Qianlong's favorite consort. But in about 20 years, she was an important consort of Qianlong. I prefer to call her consort Yu because she got her noble consort title after her death, and she was the consort from 31 to 78, which was 47 years. In different historical documents, the consort Yu was called Hai Shi, Hai Jia Shi, or Ke Li Ye Te Shi. She was from Mongolia bordered Blue Banner. Her father was a very low rank government officer. So, when she joined the Eight Banners imperial election, the Emperor Yongzheng arranged her to marry Hong Li as Ge Ge. Hai Shi was a pretty normal person. She didn't have good appearance or some talent, so Hong Li didn't like her at all. When Hong Li became the Emperor Qianlong, he only gave Hai Shi a title of Changzai, the first class female attendant. In 1738, about 2.5 years after Qianlong became the emperor, Hai Shi was promoted to Guiren, the noble lady, which was still a lower rank concubine. Qianlong never signed a special character as Hai Shi's feng hao. So, Hai Shi always used her last name as Feng Hao. The first class female attendant Hai and the noble lady Hai. In 1741, the noble lady Hai gave birth to Qianlong's fifth son, Yongqi. Because of giving birth a son, the noble lady Hai was promoted to Yupin, the noble concubine Yu. In beginning of 1745, the noble consort Gao was hopelessly sick. Qianlong decided to widely promote the imperial women to parade for the noble consort Gao. In this promotion, the noble consort Gao was promoted to the imperial noble consort. The noble concubine Yu luckily got the consort Yu title. Then, Consort Yu kept in this rank until she passed away. The Consort Yu became important with her son became the favorite son of Qianlong. Qianlong started to pay attention to Yongqi when Yongqi was 5 years old. Yongqi was a talented kid. He could quickly, fully understand the knowledge learned from the class. Because Qing royal family really cared about prince education, so Yongqi became Qianlong's favorite son. In 1763 summer, Qianlong stayed in the old summer palace. A fire broke out in the old summer palace. When other people hurriedly escaped, Yongqi still thought about his father. He carried Qianlong on his back and brought Qianlong to safe. I think this accident made Qianlong finally decide to choose Yongqi as the crown prince. After Yongqi saved Qianlong, Qianlong gave some valuable gifts to Consort Yu as rewards. So, I guess, when Yongqi was alive, Qianlong treated the Consort Yu well, although he didn't like her. Unfortunately, Yongqi only lived for 25 years. 4 months after Yongqi's death, Qianlong's step-empress passed away. So, I guess, if the image of the consort Yu was included in Xinxie Zhiping Tu, is there possible that Qianlong deleted consort Yu's image and the step empress image at the same time. Because Qianlong was mad at consort Yu that she didn't protect Yongqi very well. Again, just my opinion. According to Qing dynasty inner court rules, when the imperial women turned 50, they lost their qualification of sleeping with the emperor. But when consort Yu was 70, Qianlong still allowed her to accompany him. I guess they together memorized their beloved son, Yongqi. Because according to the official documents, in late time, Qianlong really missed his talented son, Yongqi, especially after he had to choose Yongyan as his heir. In 1792, the consort Yu passed away at 78. Qianlong posthumously promoted her to the noble consort. Although the noble consort Yu's funeral was held using the noble consort standards, but her funeral process was much less than the noble consort Qing and the noble consort Xin. According to the ancient Chinese traditions, after people passed away, their close family members should wear mourning for them. But Qianlong didn't allow Yongqi's wife and son to wear mourning for noble consort Yu. The reason was unknown. Thank you for watching this video. See you soon.